is your life is replete with priceless moments. Is not he better than your gods? Who responds to the distressed one when he calls him, and who removes the evil? And when my slaves ask you, O Muhammad, concerning me, then answer them, I am indeed near to them by my knowledge. I respond to the invocations of the supplicant when he calls on me without any mediator or intercessor. An Arab poet said, the patient one is worthy of achieving his goal, and the one addicted to knocking on doors is worthy of entering. Your life is replete with priceless moments. Related to poignant experiences in his journals. The first was when he almost drowned on the shores of Beirut. He was drowning and time was running out for him when he was finally rescued and carried unconscious to land. In the brief moments of struggle before losing consciousness, he recalls his utter submission to his Lord and his wish of returning to life, even if it was for an hour, to renew his faith, to do good deeds, and to try to reach the pinnacle of belief. The second instance was when he accompanied a caravan traveling from Syria to Mecca. While in the desert of Tabuk, they lost their way and wandered aimlessly for 3 days. Their situation worsened when their supply of food and drink began to run out. Everyone felt that death might very well be imminent. At this point, he stood up and gave a speech to the people. It was tantamount to a farewell speech to life. It was a heartfelt sermon that moved both himself and his audience to tears. He felt his faith increase and the truly felt that none could save or help them except Allah, the Exalted, the All High. Whoever is in the heavens and on earth begs of him its needs from him every day. He has a matter to bring forth, such as giving honor to some, disgrace to some, life to some, death to some. And many a prophet fought in Allah's cause, and along with him fought large bands of religious learned men. But they never lost heart for that which did befall them in Allah's way, nor did they weaken nor degrade themselves, and Allah loves the patient ones. Verily, Allah loves those strong believers who challenge their enemies with patience and stamina. They don't give up, feel hopeless, or allow themselves to be humiliated at the hands of others. Instead, they struggle, strive, and toil, and these are the taxes that a believer must pay for the ultimate property in this world: faith in Allah, His Messenger, and His religion. The strong believer is better and more beloved to Allah than the weak believer, and in each of them there is good. Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, inserted one of his fingers into a crevice of the cave in order to protect the Prophet from a scorpion, and he himself was bitten in the process. The Prophet read upon him some Quranic, some upon him some Quranic verses, and he became cured by the permission of Allah. Imam Arastantara, what is the secret to your bravery? For you are known for your ability to overpower men. He replied, put your finger in your mouth, and let me put mine in yours. Each put his finger into the mouth of the other, and each one of them began to bite the finger of the other, slowly increasing in intensity. Within a very short span of time, the man could hold out no longer, and he let out a shrill scream. And so Antara loosened the hold his jaws had on the man's finger. Antara said, this is how I overpower champions in other words, with patience and forbearance. A believer's spirits are raised when he appreciates that he is in a close proximity of Allah's mercy, kindness, and forgiveness. He feels Allah's protection and care with an intensity of feeling that is proportionate to his belief. And there is not a thing but glorifies his praise, but you understand not their glorification. Farmers in this country sometimes pass their time while sowing the earth by chanting. A dry seed in a dry country, in your hands, O Creator of the heavens and the earth. Tell me the seed that you sow in the ground. Is it you that make it grow, or are we the grower? The eloquent orator, Abdul Hamid, who was blind, ascended the podium to give a sermon. He took a date palm tree of leaf out of his pocket, and on it was written Allah in beautiful writing. He then proclaimed to the congregation, look at the tree with its fresh branches. Who made it grow? And decorated it with green. He is Allah, who is all-powerful, all-capable. Those who attained the sermon broke out into tears. He is the creator of the heavens and the earth. His signs are imprinted throughout the universe and all of creation. Pronounces him to be the creator, the one with perfect qualities and the only one who deserves to be worshipped. Our Lord, you have not created all this without purpose. Glory to you.